Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back to a brand new episode, brand new installment of macombmetalcore podcast. Thank you guys for joining me on this beautiful Monday night. Yes, I'm doing these videos back to back. If you're watching these, then yes, I did do them back to back. And yes, I did take my jacket off because I hate looking at the thumbnails back to back, and I'm wearing the exact same thing. I feel like a loser who doesn't write episodes, and ain't that ironic? Haha, but anyway, ladies and gentlemen, as I was saying in my last video, and for my new listeners, if you're just here for Bring Me the Horizon, welcome. Thank you for joining me. But as I was saying, New Music Friday, loaded, stacked to the brim. Like, I couldn't even handle it. Like, it was like hours of listening, trying to decipher things. Hours and hours. I usually try and hold off all reactions till I do them live here, but I just couldn't wait till today. And so I decided that I'm just going to listen to them, and then I'm just going to do reactions to them anyway. Because that's who I am, man. Like that's just what I do for you guys, because I'm awesome like that. And so they're not live reactions. But, ladies and gentlemen, one of the greatest, most influential metal bands of all time. I don't care if you don't like them nowadays. If you were a fan of them back in the day, you're always a fan of Bring Me the Horizon. They dropped a brand new single, Darkside, this past Friday. Their new album was already supposed to be out by like a month. Some production problems happened and whatnot. And you know what? We didn't get it yet, but that's okay because they just released a new song this past weekend, and I listened to it, and I'm a fan. There's a lot of people I know, not really that I know, because everybody who I know likes Bring Me the Horizon, but I see a lot of people on the internet talking bad about Bring Me the Horizon and what they're doing now. They want to go back to Pray for Plagues and Suicide Seeds, blah, 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 all that. But Bring Me the Horizon is not that young anymore. It's what all these bands do. They're not these young kids anymore. They're grown adults. They're trying to please people. And they do. It doesn't matter if it's softer, if it's heavier. It doesn't matter what Bring Me the Horizon does. If they put out a track, you know it's going to be a banger because that's just what they do. And that's exactly what they did in this new song, Darkside. I'm a fan of what they've been doing lately. I'm a big fan of the punk thing that they've got going on and like the emo thing they got going on, and they get little screams in there. Sounds like a little it's just like all their stuff combined into one. A lot of people didn't like Amo. I loved Amo. A lot of people loved Posthuman One. It's one of my favorite albums of them. I'd say it's top saying album of theirs is top three is tough. There's so many ones, but I'd probably put that up there after Suicide Season and Semper Eternal. I think that Posthuman is number three, in my opinion. But anyway, just getting back to it. Bring Me the Horizon, doesn't matter if it's heavy or if it's softer, if it's punk, if it's metal, if it's screaming, if it's some happy guitar riffs. It don't matter. If they put out a track, people who like Bring Me the Horizon are going to love it because Bring Me the Horizon fans are diehard fans. And that's exactly what I am, diehard Bring Me the Horizon fan. Been lucky enough to see him twice, and I'm waiting for the day I can see him for the third time. Because boy, oh boy, does Oli put on an insane show. The whole band does. The production, the music, the vocals, everything about it. Spot on, perfect. I love Bring Me the Horizon. I love what they're doing, and I will continue to love them till the day that I die, and I'm no longer listening to Bring Me the Horizon. But anyway, I'm real excited to listen to this song again. I'm a big fan of it, and I'm excited to listen to it here with you guys. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe if you like this video. If you hate it, then just don't do anything negative because that kind of hurts my feelings. But anyway, ladies and gentlemen, this is Darkside by Bring Me the Horizon. Let's go. Let's have some fun. Yeah. Like, just going in, you're already like, we probably ain't getting no Suicide Season, Pray for Plagues, there are screams in this track. I love that sound right there. Like, just the way he says it over and over is so good, and I love it. He's just so good at singing. It's unreal. I also love, every time he says again in this song, it's real satisfying in your ears. I can't explain why. It's perfect tone. Oli don't miss, baby. Oli don't miss.
Can't stop bleeding. Free in the morning, like it's left, so we can't. 6 feet in the
Then you get a subtle, like background scream from Oli. Perfect touch on it. Haunting. Go British Metalcore, baby. Little scream there for the throwback fans. Little EDM right there. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's so catchy. It's catchy. Like, how can you listen to a song and be like, you know what, that's a good song. You're like, man, like I miss old Bring Me Horizon, which like sometimes I do too. But come on, if they're putting out stuff like this, are you really upset? Can you turn me off the ledge again? If there's one thing I also love is that the last line in the song where he just screams, he just screams, can you take me off the ledge again? And there's no music going on. It's just Oli. It sounds so good. It's so cool. It's perfect ending to the track. And if you don't like New Bring Me the Horizon, I completely understand. And I get it. I understand. But man, you got to give it more of a shot. The past couple singles that they put out, they had Amen, Lost, I Die For You, trying to think. There's a couple more of them, I think. But everything that they put out lately has had this more upbeat, fun vibe, more punk, more emo, kind of like. But they're still sticking to their very subtle throwback roots with just a little scream here and there. A background scream, even. It's perfect. And they do it so well. It's fun. It makes you want to dance. But not in like a violent way. If you're just here for the spirit from the Spirit Box video, that song makes you want to dance in a violent way. This makes you want to just have a good time and just enjoy life, because that's what Bring Me the Horizon brings you, is just joy, because they don't put out bad songs. And if you disagree, I'm gonna have to subtly disagree with you here, my friend. But I love Bring Me the Horizon. I love this track. I love everything they're doing. I cannot wait for Next Gen to come out. Cannot wait. I'm counting the days, counting the minutes. I just want an official date announcement. And if that has happened already, and I'm a fool, then oops, my bad. But I'm not aware of anything at this current moment in my life. So I just need an album release date, and I need to hear the whole album and just listen and enjoy. Bring Me the Horizon is back as soon as this album comes out. I love everything they're doing. I'll support them till the day I die. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining me today. We got two new videos coming tomorrow. A live reaction, I haven't listened to it yet, of Ice Nine Kills' new track, and a Beartooth album review of The Surface, which I got so much to say about that. So if you're new here, like, comment, subscribe, because you guys are not going to want to miss those two videos. If I'm live reacting to an Ice Nine Kills song, you can bet yourself that the music video is going to be in the corner of that video, and you can bet yourself that I got a lot to say about the new Beartooth album, and boy, oh boy, am I excited for it. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so, so much, and I'll catch you guys in the flip tomorrow. I'm out.